Hello, I'm Gavin Harry and you're watching another 15 minute challenge. So let's go take some pictures. Now today we're in a fantastic garden. It should give us plenty of photo opportunities, lots of flowers, but the weather's not been particularly kind. It's literally just stopped raining and hopefully in the next 15 minutes it won't start again. But there's no time to waste, so I'm going to start off with some of these beautiful red flowers over here and just get some nice little shots here, just to get something in the bag. Okay, let's keep coming down here, see what else we can find. So I'm going to set a nice small aperture. This lens goes all the way down to 1.8. So let's try something really small. Let's try 2.5. That should really blur that background out nicely and give a lovely diffuse background. But just to be on the safe side as well, we'll increase the aperture just to make sure we get everything in focus. There's always a chance that you can end up with a too small depth of field and get stuff blurred when it should be sharp. Pond down here, so I think we'll head down to the pond. Yeah. So you've always got to look out for good stuff. Just through here, just where it's been raining, we've got a little bit of rain on these bits of grass, and it should make some nice pictures. And this is where the one lens bit gets a bit difficult, because I could really do with a macro lens here and I haven't got one. So let's make the most of what we've got. We'll use a very small aperture, f1.8, and try and go for an interesting angle instead. Very wet. Okay, and here as well, we've got a couple of leaves that have fallen into this. This is Gunnera. Not really a plant expert. We'll see if we can get these as well. Okay, right. Let's head to where we were originally going. Over to the pond. No, definitely no wide shot, but that doesn't mean to say you can't get a wide shot. What you can simply do is just take a series of pictures and then stitch them together in Photoshop to make your wide shot for you. Pattern on this bench here, so I'm going to try and get a close-up of that and take my life in my hands, just stand up on the very very slippery chair, because again with the limitations of a 50mm lens I can't quite get the composition right, but that looks pretty good. Yeah, now that's very good indeed. Stop right there, look, how can I walk past this? Little drops of water, almost asking to be photographed. That's going to be excellent. Really, really nice. Again, really shallow depth of focus, 1.8. Beautiful. That's actually, I think, probably my favourite picture so far. At least on the back of the camera anyway. Very good. Just to isolate it from the background. Good stuff. Okay, so we've got this nice little thing, not quite sure what it is. But it's got to be a good photograph. We've got to get a picture of this. Let's get down a little bit. Okay. I think we've got time for one more picture. Let's go and have a look down here. There's a little patch of flowers just down here. These could make a good picture. Now, we've lost the good light, totally gone. And we're getting a really, really slow shutter speed. So I'm just going to increase the ISO put it up to 400 just to try and get as much light into the camera as I can. And with my wide open aperture f8, that's giving me a nice fast shutter speed for a nice sharp picture. Let's come down here and try a different angle on this shot. Surprising how changing the angle completely changes the picture. And we've literally moved, 6 inches. But that just makes it so much more interesting picture. That's much better. Awesome, there you go. Okay, and there we are. Our time is up. We've now finished our 15 minutes of photographs. And, well, looking at the back of the camera, it looks like we've got some pretty good pictures in the bag. But what we're going to do now is get these into Photoshop and see what we can make of our 15-minute photo session.